Hi, welcome back to the latest edition of the Roundtable. I am your host, Stephen. Today I'll be talking about The Tipping Point, which is the seventh studio album from the British band Tears for Fears. If anybody knows them or remembers them, these guys were quite big in the 80s with songs like Shout, Everybody Wants to Rule the World, Mad World, Women's in Chains, Sowing the Seeds of Love. They were a very popular pop band back in the 80s. But they were a very different sounding pop band. They liked big, bold ideas. They pushed the envelope. Their name was actually derived from Arthur Janoff's Primal Scream Therapy. So you knew these guys weren't your regular 80s pop band. And it showed in their albums. This one is their first studio album in about 17 years. And it's their first since their criminally underrated Everybody Loves a Happy Ending, which is a very, very good pop album. Very Beatlesque. But I digress. We're talking about The Tipping Point. So here we go. This is a 10-track album. It's about 42 minutes long. This album comes from the death of Roland Ozobal's wife, who died from alcohol-related dementia. And this is him coming to terms with it. This is an album that makes the listener take stock in their emotions, their spirituality, their mental health. This is back to Tears for Fears, what they're known for, pushing that envelope, getting you to look at yourself. This is back there. This is returning back to like the hurting where you got to really look at things. You know, this is a very complex album, and I think long-term fans will be quite pleased with it. It's not your typical pop album, although it is. There are a couple of upbeat songs. It is very. It's an emotional album, but it's not. Not like Adele's last album where it's very, sad all the time that, you know, you can't listen to all. This one you can listen to the whole album, but you're hearing that this guy is went through something and is trying to come out of it and showing that journey. And I thought that was very refreshing from the album. It's a very warm album in a sense that these two guys, Kurt Smith and Roland Ozobal, sat in a room together and worked together to make this album. So you can hear the intimacy in the tracks, and that's what I liked about it. And what also I liked about it is most bands were talking about the outside world during COVID, how everything is stopped. This is an album that takes stock of your internal self as opposed to looking outward. You're looking inward on this album. That's what I think makes it very, very interesting. My favorite tracks would have to be the Tipping Point title track, which is basically Ozobal coming to the fact that his wife is not going to make it. You know, this is there's no happy ending on this one. No Small Thing, which is the one of the singles, very acoustic driven number. Break the Man, which is basically their catchiest song in about 30 years, and basically I guess them celebrating female strength. It's a sequel to Woman in Chains. If anybody remembers that song, this is the sequel. What else? Please Be Happy. If I remember correctly, the title. When it's, you know, him trying to find happiness because he's already surrounded in all this depression. And the lyrics in a nutshell is, if you lay in the grave, you see the ghosts. You know, so it's basically you make the world you've created. So it's a very deep album. I liked it. I liked it for that part that it's a very, again, it's different from other albums from this time, from COVID and the pandemic, where everybody was looking outward, how it's affecting everything. This album makes you look inward. And I thought that was refreshing about this. So Tears for Fears are back. I hope this one doesn't get lost in the shuffle like 2004's album was. I think this deserves to be in your collection. I'm going to make this my album of the month for the month of, I know we're coming to March. So the month of March will be Tears for Fears. If anybody is not familiar with them, they're kind of two guys kind of doing what Adele does. Taking big ideas, emotional ideas, putting them to song. Tears for Fears in a nutshell. The Tipping Point. 10 tracks, 42 minutes. What else can you say? It's just an album that's going to make you think. And I think sometimes we need that. And I think these guys do it well. And it's just a well-played, well-produced, well-sounding, well-written album. If you take the time to listen to it, you're going to, I think it's going to push you to grow. And I like that, the idea sometimes that pop can do that. So with that being said, I'm giving it, my album of the month is A Tipping Point from Tears for Fears, their seventh studio album. And I'm wishing everybody the very best. Live the dream. And all our thoughts and prayers are those of the Ukraine, okay? So take care. Bye.